All right. Hey, we have Deb Rose here, Chief Operating Officer at Prelude Homes and Services, a manager and developer of senior living properties. We're going to talk about the rise in senior housing and specifically talk about Prelude Village, which is a new senior living project in Woodbury that's made up of single family homes. Hey, Deb, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Of course. First, can you tell me a little bit about what you do?
I have been in the long-term care industry for over 40 years, but my primary role with Prelude Homes and Services is I serve as the Chief Operating Officer. So I oversee the development of our properties as well as the daily operations of our properties, providing supervision and direction and leadership to our director team that basically does the majority of the work.
Awesome. How did you get into this industry?
You know, it was more by default than on purpose. I did an interim job just to fill in the blank once I graduated from college as a social worker. And at that time was just doing a temporary fill-in with a senior community, actually thinking that I was going to work with youth. But ironically, having just committed to this short-term gig, I'll call it. I fell in love with serving and supporting and working with seniors, and I've never left. So it was not the career path I thought I was going down, but I'm grateful for it, and it has been the richest experience I think I could have imagined having from a career perspective.
Awesome. So you have this long range perspective. Can you tell me kind of broadly, what trends are you seeing with senior living developments in Minnesota right now?
Well, there's an abundance of them, first and foremost. I think, you know, because I consider the senior living or the continuum of care serving as a broad brush across the independent, the assisted living, as well as the skilled nursing facility environments. And so I think what I'm seeing is that the nursing homes aren't going away as much as I think the assisted livings are increasing, with a broader brush as well as a greater competency to care for people that have higher healthcare needs. But as it relates to the independent side of things, I am seeing more and more individuals choosing not to live in their single family home, but looking for a way to eliminate the responsibilities that go with a single family home, as well as the isolation that sometimes occurs as people age and are less able to be as mobile out and about and in a position to be successful and safe. And yeah. So I think more and more options becoming available to people as they age.
Cool. You know, we also know that Minnesota's population is aging right now. Beyond that, why do you think kind of this independent senior housing is such a hot market right now?
Well, I think this last year in particular, with the way the real estate market was, seniors that were living in their independent home in a community saw an opportunity to capitalize on selling their homes. I think in many cases as well, people had lived in their home for decades, found that they no longer needed a 5-bedroom house, 4 bathrooms to clean when it was either 1 or 2 individuals, and looking for an opportunity, as I said earlier, to live in a community with individuals that would be kind of at the same place in life, but really didn't need care and service. They just needed support and socialization.
Yeah. Do you think this has broader effects on the housing market too?
Can you ask me that question again?
Do you think the growing trend for senior housing has broader effects on the real estate market right now?
Actually, I think it does, because there are a number of seniors that have continue to live successfully in their single family homes in a community, in a neighborhood, and with an alternative available that doesn't require them to live in a high rise or live in an apartment building, which is not what they've been accustomed to. There's been an opportunity to sell their single family home because one, the real estate market has been relatively hot. And when you have an alternative that can fulfill the majority of what your single family home has provided you, but having less space to be responsible for, I think it's been advantageous for those looking for a home, as well as those looking to sell a home.
Definitely. Getting more specific, tell me a little bit about Prelude Village. How did this single family seniors home idea for Prelude Village come about, and how do you think it will be, you know, received by tenants compared to like a senior apartment?
Well, the concept was actually a vision from our CEO, Phil Domer, who has a passion and a desire to serve seniors differently. And that's why Prelude Homes and Services, who primarily supports people with dementia, was originally born. And having served individuals that not necessarily both individuals need to be in an assisted living or in a memory care unit, we have encountered over the course of time many individuals that want to be close to their loved one, but their home is far away, or they are in a spot where they no longer want to retain the responsibility of caring for their single family home in the community. Yeah. And with the feedback that we've received from families and their loved ones, it seemed as though that there was a great opportunity for us to serve seniors in a different way. And again, there are individuals that want and desire and long for multiple people living in one building, still having the privacy of their apartment or their home. And then there are those that want to be able to drive their car into the garage, carry their groceries through a door, and be directly into their home. And that's what Prelude Village is able to be able to accommodate. It has a high level of independence, and yet there's the support around the community, I'm going to call our Prelude Village our community, to be able to ensure that it's safe, as well as they have the support, they have the socialization, and yet they have the independence and the autonomy. And I believe that there are people that don't want to park in a parking garage and grab the grocery cart, put the things that they purchased at Target in that, and take an elevator to the fourth floor down the hallway and into their home.
Yeah. So is this
a great alternative?
Yeah. So is this a newer concept?
It is. It is and it isn't. Prelude Homes and Services actually built a twin home in White Bear Lake 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. And the property, it's essentially serving the 55 and older without all of the support that we've built into and designed to be part of the Prelude Village. And those properties have been full since the day that the buildings opened, and we've received a significant amount of feedback that has affirmed that the lifestyle and the floor plan and the resources that are available in that very, very small two twin home model was meeting with success. And it seemed as though we could capitalize on what we had done, what we had learned, and be able to expand it into the Woodbury community and be able to support more individuals in what I'll call kind of a boutique community.
Yeah.
Supporting cool. Seniors.
Sure. Yeah. So are there other things you're seeing within, you know, I've been hearing about senior apartments for quite a while, and now you're talking to me about this, Prelude Village. Is your company, or is the market more broadly looking at other strategies for creating senior living that's maybe different than what we've seen before?
Are you talking about, is Prelude looking at expanding itself into other alternatives?
Yeah.
I believe, or at this present time, our strategic plan is to capitalize on what we're doing currently. I think we're excellent as a memory care provider, but I believe that this small boutique community is being well received and should be capitalized on. So we're exploring different properties that we may be able to expand this same model to, again, looking for being able to create a small community for individuals at the same place in their life to be able to live together without feeling like they're living together.
Sure, definitely. Are you seeing other, maybe beyond Prelude, other parts of the market looking at different ways of, addressing senior housing?
I think the amenities that some other organizations are adding are intending to kind of accommodate some of the trends. For example, I've seen some senior communities that have added pickleball courts because that's a new craze. It's a sport that is available to people at various ages and stages in life. So that's just an example. So I would say that the things that are becoming unique are some of the amenities that might be available in a community. And a lot of that has to do with the real estate as well as the interest of the population that might choose to live there. As far as the physical spaces, I think it's hard to be too creative. I think it really comes down to the amenities and the services. And each person may have a different need and a different desire for what those services and amenities might be that will fulfill the things that they've either done in their past or they'd like to explore in their future.
Yeah, for sure. Great. I don't really think I have any other questions. Was there anything we didn't talk about that you wanted to touch on?
In regards to senior housing?
Yeah.
In general.
Or, you know, anything really.
Well, I'd love to explain or describe Prelude Village a little bit more if there's an opportunity for that.
Absolutely. Go ahead.
Prelude Village is located in the community of Woodbury, and it's located on the most historic property in the community. There is a home that is our clubhouse that was one of the first homes built in the Woodbury community. And it's considered a historic property. And I believe that adds a little bit of additional charm to the village. We have 10 homes currently built with the plan and plan for us to add 9 more by summer of next year. Mm-hmm. The advantage of the village homes are that they're all single level living and they all have attached garages. We provide all of the interior maintenance. So whether it's your furnace filter, whether it's your light bulbs, whether it's your softener salt, whatever might be needed to support the safety and success of someone living in one of our village homes is what we provide. We do all of the grounds, whether it's snow, yard, garbage, all of those kinds of things, Wi-Fi is included. So the one thing that I think is really advantageous is all the things that might have otherwise been the burden of a homeowner, we essentially take care of. So I consider it carefree and confident living. And yet there's resources available on the property, in the community, to help coordinate services as people age in place, whether it's that they need groceries delivered or they had an event that now requires some assistance from a home care agency. Those types of things, we have a concierge on site to be able to help navigate and coordinate some of the things that might otherwise be challenging for them to figure out because it's something they've not had the responsibility to do in the past. So it's boutique because it's small. The most that it will accommodate is 19 homes. We have the clubhouse, a place for people to gather, events that can happen there, a place for them to reserve for large family gatherings, birthday parties, parties, whatever they may feel that they have a preference or a desire to do. And again, it's small. The opportunity to know 19 neighbors intentionally is something that will be available through the village, along with then the support as people hopefully choose to age in place.
Yeah, so it can be for kind of more independent seniors and then as they age in place to get more of those services as time goes on.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
Cool.
And again, it's like living in your home, but having the knowledge that there's somebody that's going to be available to you, kind of keeping an eye out in the event that there's something that is out of what appears to be the norm for someone, and then being able to support in whatever fashion that might be.
Yeah, great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time. It was really great to talk to you.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it very much.
Of course. All right. Take care.
Bye-bye.